Yo, what's up? What's up, everybody? I'm working on more spoiler alert story elements today. So, let's get to it. Let's get right to it. Too many. Ay, ay, ay. How you doing, sound dogs? So what's first on the list, huh? All right. So if you go onto the bridge during the countdown, you're doing good? Awesome. I'm doing good, man. Things are going great here. Yeah. I'm drinking a kombucha. Working on these story elements. I've been working on message boxes and stuff this morning. What's up, Pedro? Yeah, so I got all that error reporting code working, so it uploads the log.txt and the saves.txt for a player to my server whenever they allow it. So like I can even show you. Awesome, powerful kombucha. Day three of spoilers, yep. So check it. Like if let's say your run does not complete successfully, you don't have game exited cleanly, then when you run the game, ooh, excuse me, it'll do this little message box and say, do you want to send an error report to the developer? You can choose yes always, and it will always do this in the future. It doesn't even prompt you. But if you do yes, it sends that your log.txt and saves.txt to my server. So I can try and figure out what the hell's wrong. So that's pretty cool, right? Like automatic error reporting. And yeah, so I've been working on getting that to be smooth and working well on Windows and Linux this morning. It works really well on Mac. And the next thing I gotta do is make it so on Windows, it can change the text of the message box buttons. So on like Windows, it only has the option of yes, no, cancel, abort, retry, ignore. You can't change the text unless you do it manually. So I'll be working on that later. And then also I gotta manually implement message boxes for Linux because there's no such thing. So anyways, a little bit left to do with that, but other than that, like the game's come along really well. Like getting this checksumming working, that's really good to be able to make it so the game just knows that if it has a corrupt download, that's awesome. And it also so and the byproduct of that is it knows if the player is cheating. So if you try and go, not cheating, but you can totally cheat and it won't get it get won't catch it. But if you change your data, I mean, if a player goes in and tries to change the data so that, for example, the final boss only has one hit point, the game would know. And it'd be like, okay, I'm gonna allow you to play like this, but I'm not gonna update your score to the leaderboard. Yeah, no message boxes in Linux APIs. Linux APIs are kind of sparse. If you want to look into Linux's APIs, it's all xlib. So if you just look up xlib programming manual, here it is. Christopher Tranch, his website. I think he's the guy that started this all. But it's pretty old school. xlib's been around a long time and really hasn't changed much. And which is, kind of in the Linux spirit, I guess. But yeah, that's how you would do things in that's how you do Windows stuff, Windowsy things like creating a window, stuff like that. So, all right, yeah. So I'm gonna go into the first element for today's tasks is I'm gonna work on making it so there's some kind of story element for if you go onto the bridge during the countdown. And first, I'm going to set it up so we're only doing a part of this story element here because this happens a lot. I don't want to skip through it. Wait, I want to. Not that one. But this one there. So that's set up. I already know that I need to have some kind of story. The story system needs to know if it is during a countdown. So that's in, I know it's in story system.cpp. I forget what the function's called though. I think it's in, is it in run action? No, it's not run action, but I know it's where it sets up like fluxing. That's a string that I use. There it is, story status fluxing. Okay, so we need a story element for if the if the render system is doing its countdowny thing. So I'll yank two lines. All right. If render system, is it has countdown? It is, it's just has countdown. Oop. I want to change to there. There we go. Okay, so now we've got, whoops. Countdown. So we have, now the story system knows if it has that whole render system countdown thing. And so I want to do some, where the ship bridge, so looking for the ship bridge actions. All the ship bridge actions should never happen if you're doing a countdown. That's ship bridge one, ship bridge 1B, same thing. Ship bridge two. Not countdown. And ship bridge three. Not countdown. That's okay. That's all the story elements we have so far. So now we need a story element for if it is the countdown. So I'll yank. I'm just gonna do a visual yank here. Actually, no, I could do, let's not do visual. Visual is not a good habit to get into. Yank 13J. Yes, I'm starting to get good at this. This is great. So awesome. So this action is gonna be called ship bridge four. This is if we're on the ship, Z, if we have Captain Tusk, if it is counting down, and it doesn't really matter what else we have, and yeah, I guess uptime and idle, those can be, and near Rosenbaum, that's cool. Okay, I guess there's really no need to animate. But we do want to do dialogue or yeah, we could do some dialogue here. And that's it. All right, so now back to our strings. We need to have some dialogue for that story element. All right. Story Ship Bridge 4. There. So now we have a dialogue element. What's up, Kavarni? We'll see how it goes. So we want to run it, see what happens. It should be able to, let's see, what it'll do is it'll do a truncated version of that one story element. I'll run out of this ship dungeon. I can save it here and just start over, and it should do the same story element again. Cool. How you been, Kavarni? What's up, man? When we get out here, it'll do one little story element there, where it hints and says, hey, you should try the teleporter. But if you go onto the bridge, stand here, nothing's happening when we get near there. Guys, are you disobeying my order? Abandoned ship. Cool. Now if I use the teleporter here. Is everyone asleep? Everyone's asleep! HD. And then good, I cannot teleport back to Songbringer after that. Okay. Good. That worked just fine. We got a story element for if you go back onto the bridge. I could add another one and be like, hey, what the hell are you doing? Get off here, but that's good enough for now. You're looking away. Look away. Seriously, this is total spoiler alerts, man. Total spoiler alerts. It says spoiler alert in the stream. No spoilers. Cover your eyes. Cover your ears. Earmuffs. Whoa. It's the most powerful kombucha I've ever tasted. This shit is powerful, man. It's called ginger fire and it's got like hot peppers in it. All right, good. So now the other ship bridge story elements will not play during the countdown. And we've got this other one, ship bridge 4, for if it is during the countdown. And we can take away, well, I hate having to uncomment this thing every time, but... Oh, I could just visually... indent those. Okay. So I gotta uncomment those now. Where's that at? Ship falling? There it is. Yes. Whoops. All right, is not countdown, not countdown, not countdown. And then this one little bit of code, two lines of code, that was all that was. If render system has countdown, story status, countdown, true. Very good. Very nice. Thank you. Very nice. You're in the right place. You're here. All right, so the next thing I wanted, so the teleporter only allows you to teleport to one place when you're when it's during this whole frenetic, panicky, get off the ship moment. Just allows you to go back to the crash site, your original home place on the overworld. Okay, this shouldn't be too hard. All right, so it's back in the teleporter gives you some options, and I think it's in phase. It's probably phase teleport out. God, I love Vim. Am I crazy? I'm starting to prefer Vim. It's so crazy. Is this where it gives you the options? Yeah, this is where it ticks the interface and all that. I'm not crazy. Good. Oh my God, it is, man. It totally is. I think I'm gonna hack Xcode and make it use X. I use the Xvim thing. And try that out too, cause I'm still having to use Xcode a lot, you know, especially for debugging. I do see there's an LLDB debugger. That you can integrate into Vim. Yes, I am. So you're saying I am crazy? Obviously. So we got this not interface shown thing. We want to choose the first item automatically. Oh no, that's not there. All right, so I just gotta basically work up this class so that it can basically just not give the player any options, but still just perform the teleport. Where does it actually perform the, like choose the teleport? Ah, here it is. It's where it uses the choice. Set the new area pause. Okay, let's go now. Okay, so I know how to basically, what we need to do after this is, what this does essentially is just set the new area pause. That's all it does. So we want to go new area pause equals the world's home position. And we want to do set this also so it doesn't show the interface so that it doesn't ever try and do any of that tick code there. So where does it actually launch this interface? Show HUD, cube pause, stop and drop the cube, run the animation, shoot the sword, destroy the top hat. Here's the parent node. We can still do that. Background fade layer. Oh, here it is. Here's where it runs the action to fade the background. And it sets interface shown true. Okay. Okay, so. Okay, so we want to do skip the interface. If render system, whoops. I just thought of something I should probably change in my VimRC. Ah, this keeps happening. Pressing the tab key is kind of a weird thing to press. I'm not used to it for auto completion. I'm gonna change that right now, actually. I know I could actually change in my VimRC and source my VimRC without exiting, but I'm just doing it exiting anyways because I'm not sure if that affects the plugins. Anyways, VimRC, I'm gonna change the line or the keys that allow me to do tab completion. To just enter. Let's try that. Okay, so we're back at phase, teleport, out. All right, now I was typing in render system. Okay, so there I'm using enter instead, which means I basically can't. The one drawback of using enter for choosing things from your dropdown or your autocomplete list is that if you're at the end of a line of code and you want and you're done typing in your code and you want to actually go to the next line, you actually have to escape out of your insert mode and then I guess enter insert mode again. I don't know. It's probably a way to do that. Okay, so this is if it has a countdown, then we just want to set the new area pause to be world get start pause for int z is just zero. So start pause of the home of the overworld. Otherwise, we show the interface. All right, let's see if that works. So once again, we're starting inside the ship dungeon with the whole story element for everything about to crash. Oops, wrong area. Del. Change it into the line, go back to just 10 and make sure ship all. Is off. Oh, this is gonna do this the whole story element though. Alright, I don't wanna wait through that every time. So I'm going to indent that one and this one. Oh man, I'm so stoked about Vim. I'm actually really excited to go and get a color scheme set up for my data files. It's something I've never really looked into how to do on Xcode, but so sweet to have a color scheme for that. Alright, so I use the teleporter. Should just teleport me straight to the home screen without any choice. Good! Yes, that worked. So that's a really silly bit of dialogue there. I gotta improve that. Awesome, that worked! Yeah! Okay, is there anything in that that I might have missed? I feel like I should check this twice. Oops. Oops. All right, what could I do? What could possibly break that? Well, it's not, so it should be clearing up the layer and the parent and all that, no matter what, right? So it goes into here, it still cleans up the cube. Still does its teleport position just fine. It clears the interface, which is okay. It never used the interface, so that's all right. Clearing the interface twice is okay. And this next phase being closed, that's totally okay as well. That only happens at the end of a dungeon. And then yeah, it removes the parent and removes the other layers. It still fades out the layer even though it never faded in, but that's okay. All right, yeah, this is good. All right, okay, so I looked over this twice. Let me just make sure the tick function doesn't have anything that would be maybe missed. Flux timer, ticking the interface. Dialogue sound, new area pause invalidated. Don't need to do that. It just has to do with setting the new area pause. And this is if it fails to teleport, it cancels and does teleport in. So it doesn't need to do that. Okay, good. Yeah. Let's add a little more comment though. Okay. It's nice to have a day where things are kind of easy. Okay, I don't need to check in story on this one, but I do want to check in flux. And that's just one tiny bit of code. All it did was say if we have a countdown, here's a new area pause, don't run the interface. Teleport only to the overworld home pause if has count. down. And I'll check it one last time. Just because I'm a programmer at heart, I'm super pragmatic. I check things twice. I'm like Santa. I'm making a list and checking it twice. Ay, ay, ay. It's kombucha. It's like drinking fire. Trying to mess up things, mess up the code, something's gotta go wrong. Peeing Horse, what a cool name. You sold your T460 today? You ordered a MacBook Pro? Sweet, man. How could I possibly mess this up? Maybe I'll try going downstairs. Try using the teleporter. Oh shit, it allows me to use the teleporter here? Oh, I found a bug. All right. Let's fix that. It allowed me to use the teleporter. Why is that? I think it's in use teleporter. It's your first Apple device after the iPod Touch 2G. Right on. What did I ask for Christmas? This awesome sleeping bag. I can't wait for this. Oh my God. And rock climbing shoes. I want rock climbing shoes and a sweet sleeping bag. So next summer I can do some awesome backpacking. Alright, where's that little bit where... Yeah, here's where it doesn't allow you to use it in the ship dungeon. So we also want to be... If you're in the ship dungeons... Oh, right. If we were... So, okay, that would have not have caught that bug. So let's undo that. We want to be checking Constance. Check it out. It filled out the little dot dots there. That's cool. I really am. If I could stream from a national park, I would. And I do spend 8 hours a day in a closet. More like 10. Oh, it's just... It kills me sometimes. God, dude, that's like the one thing. If I had a lot of money, like if I already was like a really successful developer or something, I could hire people so that I could go hiking more. Oh, it'd be so great. So we want to go Constance get level Z. So that if we go inside one of the tunnels, we still can't use the teleporter. Let's do that again. I know, we have so much natural beauty. Especially, dude, California, the whole West Coast, we have all these amazing mountains all the way to the Rockies. What about you guys? What did you ask for Christmas, Pedro? And salad. What do you want for Christmas? Don't tell me it's your two front teeth. Alright, good. It does not let me use the teleporter. And it shouldn't let me use the teleporter here either. Good. Peeing Horse, you guys don't do gifts? That's cool. if I use a teleporter. Well, good. I'm glad I caught that teleporter bug. Alright, yay. Good. It's a good thing to double check stuff, isn't it? You don't know? You bought a Rubik's Cube for yourself? You gotta make up your mind? I like how you said mines. That's cool. All right, input system, check that in. Cannot teleport from Songbringer dungeon tunnels. Yeah, Big Mac, what's up, man? Yeah, I'm switching from Xcode to Vim slowly but surely. Starting to figure it out. Starting to get to prefer, actually, Vim over Xcode. Freudian slip. Big Mac Dev, what about you, man? What do you want for Christmas? All right, refining the ship crashing dialogue. And being able to pick up the Smith again. Let's refine this ship crashing dialogue. It's super easy. Just say something else. Oh, wait. But this is going to be different if you have the Smith. Okay, so we got to do the Smith thing first. You'd like an Xbox One? Books and a new keyboard mouse? That's a sweet gift. I need a new keyboard and mouse too. I got one of these old. This is like from 2008 and it's the Mac like keyboard and mouse. And my Mac, my mouse is so frayed that there's like literally like only three or four wires that are actually holding this together. I don't know how it still works. The other wires are just sitting there all frayed and disconnected. And there's like hair and like dirt and stuff inside it. And it clicks if I hold my hand on it. It's so weird. Do you hear that? If I just touch it. Sometimes. Oh, that's weird. Now it's not doing it. I don't know why. Sometimes it just clicks randomly. It's so amazing. So amazing. Gosh. How does that work? All right. We need a little situation. Dungeon 10. You have the magic mouse? You broke the keyboard? Oh no! Yeah, this mouse. This is the mouse that never died, though. This is the mouse with 10 lives. I don't know how it does it. It truly is magic. Let's back that up. You using Atom? Nice, man. Yeah, you gonna give him a try? It's kind of like one of those things that takes a minute to get into, but you shouldn't be too intimidated by it. Henko's like, wait till you can release. Yeah, that's a good idea. That's a really good idea. Yeah, Vim. If you're getting started with Vim, Vim Tutor is really a good thing to do. You just go Vim Tutor, and it'll get you started. If you do this, like do this more than once, you know, like do Vim Tutor and then do it again and do it again a few times, and you'll start to get used to it. And then once you'll have some kind of like breakthrough moment or whatever, where you're like, oh my God, Vim is way more efficient. And I had that moment a few weeks ago, but it's still taken me enough this much time to, like, I don't know, get comfortable with Vim. So it's tricky, but don't worry about it. You'll get it. It's like I can't even figure out how to close it. Because I'm in Vim Tutor and it uses different Vim keys than I have. I'll buy 10 mices. Vim Adventures? Yeah, Vim Adventures is a good one too. It's like a, isn't that a, just a website? Okay, am I in command mode? What am I in? I don't know what the hell. Oh, it's recording a macro? Control Q? I don't think it's that. Is it? Is it really Control Q? No. Oh, check it. Okay, Control C though got me out of whatever the hell I was doing right there. Control C for the win. Shit. Sometimes Vim, man. No, I couldn't do any colons or anything like that. It was just like stuck. But Control C, I think it was trying to record a macro. I don't know how I entered that, but yeah, you live and learn. Vim is tricky sometimes. Right, FG. All right, so we want to be in the room with the Smith. So let's go there. Yeah, I'm kind of like wondering what the hell that was. Here's the bit. Yeah, here he is. What's up, Smith? You're just still working? The ship's falling, man. You should probably get off board. We gotta get to land, man. Let's go. Come on, dude. Right, so we'll save here. And now we're gonna code it up so we can save the droid Smith. I got my saves backed up because I know I'm gonna mess it up. All right, so step one, cut a hole in the box. Step two. Step one is we need to be able to pick up the droid Smith and have him start following you. I already have this code where he does that. When you pick him up for, it's like a story element, right? Yeah. Oh yeah. This is all story based. This is so great. I shouldn't have to write too much code for this at all. So there's a story element for getting the Smith on your team. It's like it's around here. Smith join one. Yeah, if you're a pattern ship Smith, exist Smith, you have the droid Smith quest item. If you're not fluxing, set some dialogue and give the item droid Smith. Do a map application. Yeah, this should be pretty simple actually. All right, I wanna copy 11 lines. Smith join two. If we're at Z10, it doesn't matter the pattern, but we do want to have Smith, and we do want to have the droid Smith item, and we want to be not fluxing, a little bit of idle, do the dialogue Smith join two. Give item droid Smith four. Right? Yeah. Four will become, so zero is you don't have the droid Smith quest. One is you need to go pick him up. Two means you've picked him up. Three means you've dropped him off. Four means you picked him up again. So maybe this should actually be two. How did I set that up in the constants? I forget. Item join smith is 0 to 4. Okay, yeah. One is quest, two is join, three is drop, four is you picked him back up. Good. Yeah, so that's a distinct, right? There's five distinct phases, actually, of the Droidsmith quest. We don't need to do map location. And this delay, not really needed, but we'll keep it. Go back and give this some dialogue now. So, copy Smith join. Call it Smith join 2. All right, so Smith will delete to where it says Smith or change. Whoops, not shift G, C. I want to do how to do this in Vim. I want to change to where it says Smith. That didn't work. Let's try it again. Change to search for Smith. Shit, I don't know what I'm doing here. There's a better way to do this, but oh well. You live and you learn Vim slowly. Slowly but surely. You know what? Shit. Just change the whole line. Rock's going to say something like, I was trying to change the text on that line up until the point where it said Smith colon. And I know you can use searching as a motion, but I was doing it wrong. I'm not sure what I was doing wrong. I was doing CT search. Peeing horse. It's 1 a.m. Oh my God. It's so late. I know, so many of you guys were watching it so late. Over there, are you in Europe? Or Africa? Rock. CI/, yeah, that's what I was, change in. I was trying to do change to, so change all the text up until finding Smith. And I know I've done that before, it just didn't work for me at that time. After you're like, lol. All right, so we should be able to pick him up again now. See what happens. Yes, it is. Yeah, it is. Saladunks. Change to. I'll show you. He disappeared. What happened, Smith? He went away. Oh, Smithy Smith. So, for example, let's say I want to change from here to the period. I would go change to period. See that? It just deleted all that text and put me already in insert mode so I can change to that period. And I know I'll undo that. I know you can change to searching for something too, and then change to search for a period. That time it worked. Wait, no, it didn't. I guess maybe search doesn't work for that. I don't know. I thought search worked as a motion like that. Yeah, it's pretty powerful. You should check it out. What's up, Peeing Horse? Did it take longer to make the art or the coding? Definitely the coding. So much coding. Yeah. There's 70, how many thousand lines of code are in this game? 76,000 lines of code. And yeah, coding takes a long time. We know what really takes a long time though? It's not typing in text, it's not typing in code, it's testing all the goddamn code and fixing all the bugs in those 77,000 lines of code. That's what takes forever. It's so quick to draw a piece of art and put it in the game. That takes like an hour or 2 hours. But to go and actually debug code can take an entire day. So yeah, this game has been in progress for about 2 years of development. And I would say that 70% of that time has been coding. Maybe 20% of it's been art. And like 10% of it's been sound and music. Sound and music's like the easiest and quickest. I don't know why. But it's just... it's just quick for me, I guess. Rigathian, is that average, really? Oh, CT! You're right! Oh, okay, so that's what was wrong. If I wanted to change this whole line up until Smith colon, I would go change search Smith colon. Yeah, that was it. Okay. Thank you, Saladongs. Yeah, so that was how you do it. All right. So noted in my little Vim memory, T is emotion. Searching is also emotion. You can't combine the two motions, I guess. No. Yeah, you can't combine motions. I don't know. Learning slowly but surely. Really liking Vim. Okay, so we've got that dialogue in place, but it didn't pick up the Smith that time. Probably because the story action was a little messed up or something. It's in action item, where it gives you an item. The droid Smith is technically an item. It's a quest item. So yeah, if it's the item droid Smith, we're converting hero Smith to Smith. Convert hero, looks for the existing entity, and then schedules create heroes to create them again. I guess it's probably create heroes that's not set up to have a quantity Smith. Ah, here it is. So we want to do Smith if quantity Smith is 2 or 4. And let's see if the rest of this function works. Yep, this is where it deletes him. This is where it creates him. It just creates him. Yeah, it just checks the DoSmith flag. And then, yeah, quantity 3 is when you would get rid of him. I guess we're going to need quantity 5 for dropping him off again. Right? Yeah, I think so. So we'll do quantity Smith equals 5. And we need to go back here and make sure the droid Smith has the ability to be up to 5. 5 equals fixing. Oh, and then 4 is also saved. Yeah. Okay, so we should be able to pick him up now. Nice. Cool. So now Smith can come with us. We shouldn't be able to teleport. And we'll get back to the upper level of the ship. Teleport away. We should be able to teleport with Smith. Takes us back here. Now we need to be able to drop Smith off again. And so we'll do with that story element right there. So Smith is going to stay here and start fixing Jib. All right, Smith, now we got to drop you off. So what happens if I run again? I think I'll still have Smith, but I won't have that story element. Yeah, so we have Smith, no story element. Okay, so we need to be able to droid Smith. We still have quantity 4, but what's that story element called where Rock's like, ah, my ship's falling. Ah. There, oh, ship falling too. Okay, so I want to take off ship falling too. Oh, that's a. Is it really just a. I guess ship falling too is. God, this only happens on countdown done. What's up, Benoit Net? How's it going today? We got a running question. We're asking everybody, what do you want for Christmas? So, Anoinette, what do you want for Christmas? You left the window open in the bathroom and now it froze from the inside? Damn. Oh, that sucks, man. Duct tape. Duct tape it. Duct tape it closed. It's going really good here, Noah. It's working on story elements. Once again, this is a spoiler alert stream. No idea, no idea. I hear you. We got a couple of those. A girlfriend. There you go. Nice. Right on. What's up, Elkanoo? Thank you for hosting, man. You wanted to get fresh air for like 5 minutes? So wait a minute. Your shower froze in only 5 minutes? Where the heck are you? Northern Norway? Iceland? Russia? That's some cold coldness. Okay, so when we triggered this story element, this only happens, well, yeah, I guess we need a smarter story element that happens if you have this certain quantity of the droid Smith. So yeah, we'll do this. Finland. Dang. Antarctica? Oh, you forgot about it? Dang, man. We'll just do it with Smith join. Smith join, where's that at? Smith join. Okay, Smith join one, Smith join two, Smith join three, basically, or Smith drop off or something like that. Oh, all right, El Canoe, thanks a lot. We'll see you, man. Oh, sweet. Oh, so kind, Noah. Lou Smith drop two. Yank 13 J. So this is Smith drop two. This happens probably no matter the Z, but actually, yeah, we're gonna do Z zero. And this is flags has the home flag. Exist Smith. Quantity droid Smith. So we're gonna change to space. Quantity droid Smith. We have quantity droid Smith 4. We want to change that to 5. Once we're done fluxing, we have a little bit of idle. Doesn't matter the uptime. We're going to do dialogue Smith drop 2. Nat, what do you want to do? You want to keep the English names of items, or do they have a Frenchization of it? Oh, you can franchise it. Yeah. Definitely. You don't have to keep the English names. I trust you. However the heck you it's probably, you'd probably be like, oh, in French, this would sound like it would kind of fit well like this, you know? You can keep it current and modern and all that, like, stuff. Whatever kind of modern words you want to use, it's totally fine. It doesn't have to sound sci-fi. It doesn't have to sound whatever. You can use whatever words that sound appropriate. Yeah. Dialogue Smith drop 2, and then item drops Droid Smith 5. Delete that, and that should be it. And then the last thing is, well, we want some dialogue for Smith drop 2. But before I do that, I want to make sure that when I set that countdown done element here, the ship falling 2, this shouldn't have any delay after it. Okay. Okay, now we need this dialogue Smith drop 2. Oh, Smith drop 1 is what I'm looking for. All right, so change the end of the line. We'll start with Rock saying something like, See, I don't want spoiler alert. I don't want to make it. I want it to seem like Jib is dead. Like he's fully dead. I don't want to like have there really be. I want there only to be the tiniest glimmer of hope that Jib might be able to be fixed. Something like this. Okay, let's see that happen. So this story element will happen no matter what, even if, no matter what, if you happen to have the droid smith still, this should happen. So let's see if it does. No, you didn't scare anybody. Don't worry, man. It's been a quiet chat today. It's Saturday. People are out enjoying this beautiful sunny winter. Is it sunny where you're at? It's sunny where I'm at, actually. But it's cold. It's been cold here. Okay, so we've dropped him off and he starts working. That's funny. Oh, because he's going to those little ground things. Oh, but he doesn't reappear. Okay, so we got a few things to work on here to get the smith to. I just want the smith to stop right here to have Jib on the ground and Smith's just like sitting there trying to fix him. Okay, this is looking good so far. One thing I want to make a little bit better is Smith's dialogue boxes are a little too low. Let's try maybe 8 pixels higher. Yeah, and I'm working on spoiler stuff, exactly. Which is probably, and I've been making it pretty clear that I am, so I know a lot of people are not purposely not watching, so that's probably part of it. Good, yeah, his dialogue box is up and nicer and high now above him. Good. Okay, we need to have Jib on the ground. I guess I'm gonna have to spawn a Jib entity. Spawn Jib dead. Yeah. We'll need a special entity where Jib is just dead. And that's pretty easy. It's just like really, really simple, but it'll need to be a separate entity. So we'll go into data, friends, and this is more of an entity than a friend. Yeah, let's go back to entities. And we'll call this one Jib Dead. And what should be a good starting point for this? I don't know. Doesn't really matter, I guess. Bike? Yeah, I guess bike would be a good place. Copy bike to Jib Dead. So that should make us be able to spawn a Jib Dead. I think a Jib Dead is also going to need like an input component and some stuff, but we'll get that going. Okay, so let's edit that file. Data entities Jib Dead. I'll have a single animation. Change to the end of the line. Oops. Shift C. This is just Jib. I think it's just called Jib Dead. Let's see. Jib has this animation. Hurt, release, dying, die. Flicker or die? I'm not sure which one of those. Shadow. Jib. Here's Jib die. Starts off. I guess Jib die 6. Or Jib flicker. 0. But Jib die 6 is probably better. So if I change to the dot, Jib die 6, delay 1. Attributes. He has a render component. He has a reflection component, shadow component. No shadow component. He's on the ground. He has a collision component? Yeah. Well, give him a tiny collision component. This is maybe 10 by 6. No, 10 by 10 by 10. Name. Jib dead. And he does need an input component. I think that should be enough. So when we do this story element, Smith drop 2, we give item droid Smith 5. And we can spawn a Jib dead. One. All right, let's try that out. I'm not sure where on the screen it'll try and spawn him. if it did at all. He just goes running around and like working on the grass. Oh yeah, let's pick some grass up. Okay. I'll go to where it spawns an entity. And I gotta switch to Xcode so I can debug. Damn you, Xcode. You're slow editing, slow finding. Xcode is slow. Okay, let's make sure it even spawns at all. We'll start at the beginning. Oh, it doesn't even have like collision category friend or foe or anything. Just category static. Oh, we probably want that to be friend. Yeah, let's start with that being friend. No, maybe not friend, neutral. Oh, I guess it doesn't matter. Yeah, friend should work. So if you're familiar with Metroid, Super Metroid, and speedruns of Super Metroid, there's always a choice. You either kill the animals or save the animals. That's what this is. You have the choice of saving Smith. For the hope of saving Jib. So it takes you extra time to go save Smith, but Smith might, he just might fix Jib and change the ending of the game. Alright, so let's see what happens when we do this spawn. I'm trying to spawn Jib dead. The name should be just Jib dead. Quantity should be just one. Good. No item string. No teleport in, no hollow. Doesn't already have the name. It shouldn't parse an item. It unspawns all filter foes. Which I guess is alright. Okay, now it's gonna jump into area.spawn. And this is where it's gonna do farthest nearest. I guess some special logic is in order here. I guess we'll put Jib at Rock's feet. This is right where we're creating him. I guess we'll call it drop in. Make a new spawn type. K-spawn none, teleport, hollow, and we'll call this one K-spawn drop, which means you're just dropping it on the ground. K-spawn drop it is. Now, in this story element, we'll spawn jib dead one, and we'll call this one drop in. So we're dropping it right at the hero's feet. And then back here in action spawn, if it contains, well, we can keep this breakpoint, but just disable it. If it contains val drop in, we'll do k spawn drop. And then area spawn. Actually, we don't need to unspawn all of these foes, even though there's no foes on the screen. Jib! Oh, Jibby Jib! Spawn hollow. So yeah, if not type is hollow or type is drop, unspawn all. And then if it's spawn type drop, we'll put it right at the player's feet. There's no need for a special animation, nothing there. Doesn't have a timer. Oh shit. This is pretty critical right here. This should only be if not e.ai.empty. Critical. Same thing here. This doesn't have an AI at all, so screw it. There is a common sound for dropping things on the ground, I think. Isn't there? Go ahead and play that sound. No, it's not a common sound, it's a hero sound. Drop. Not this drop. There it is. Drop. Drop item. Right? I think it's drop item. Drop item. Autoref hero herp hero equals game scene hero zero hero herp herp dot profile dot play sound autocomplete. You're so slow. Oh, it's profile dot profile. Sorry, autocomplete, you're not slow. Not exactly. Drop item. And E dot position dot pause, no dot last pause equals E dot position dot pause equals hero dot position dot pause minus V3F zero, perhaps about negative 20 or so. We'll do the size of this, the collision box, which is E dot collision dot size dot Y plus 1. There, that should put him at his feet. All right. Should I set a breakpoint? Probably. Let's re-enable that breakpoint just to make sure this all goes as planned. Dropping him at the hero's feet. Why so slow? Why so slow? There's something running in the background that I'm not aware of. Game show is eating a lot of CPU right now. No, it's just the source kit indexing. God damn. Xcode's indexer is slow as shit and eats up so much CPU. But Game Show is eating up a lot of CPU right now, too. It's usually less than that. Heh. Heh. Songbringer may have crashed. Send a report. No, don't send a report. Good, we got type spawn drop. Whoops. Oh, he's there. He's totally there. But he needs Z on the ground. And he's being covered up by the bike. Okay, this time we'll put him a little to the left. What was that sound? Why did it... Oh, it played the hollow star sound. I don't need to do that. Alright, let's try putting him over to the... this way. Collision size X times a half plus 1. And let's make him play a little animation. We'll play his drop animation called drop. And this will be the same as his flickering animation. So he'll flicker and then just sit there. That's jib, 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 jib.txt. Flicker. flicker. E dot set animation. Autocomplete. There you are. So we play this animation called drop. We go next key is idle. Next repeat forever. So he'll flicker to start in. Go, runneth yourself. Man, that was a powerful booch. Powerful stuff. So powerful you have to say it in a whisper. No Smith. What's up? Where'd the Smith go? Oh. I guess I saved it. Droid Smith 4. I guess this should have a no save because Smith drop 2 got saved and it's just easier to make this one a no save, right? Quantity Droid Smith 4. Yeah, if your Quantity Droid Smith is ever 4, it should do this if you're on the home screen. Cool. Tell. Oh, his Z. Let's fix his Z. Dip dead. Render. Z order. Low. Plus 0. Plus like 5. Jibs on the ground. He has no collision. Friend static. What ground static, actually? Ground static so that the Smith would actually go and scan him and stuff. Right, did that work? Let's see. Oh no, it turned him into a diamond. Okay, he doesn't need the category friend. Okay, I guess the droid smith can have some special logic or whatever to handle this situation where he needs to work on Jib and not like go walk around the whole screen. He's acting like he's inside the ship engine trying to go walk around and fix the engine and stuff. Or the ship servers. What's up, professional novice? Spoiler alert. What's up, space my name? Spoiler alert. How you guys doing? What you doing? What you want for Christmas? Oh, good. This time we have a good collision box for him. But do we really need a collision box? I guess so. But why is it so off-center? I guess it's just how it is. It's probably better to make it so you can walk on top of him. You want a sugar mama? Yeah! Nice, man. Yay! Alright, the next thing we gotta do is get the smith so he can go into a mode where he, fixes Jib, but not while runs around the whole screen, so I think the smith already has some special modes for everything. Right? Sequence to follow. When he starts following, that's when he's in mode 8, and he goes to mode 1. Stop, mode, follow, follow. That's like mode 1, mode 1, mode 1. Mode 1, mode 3, mode 3, 1. Oh yeah, so next target, that's when he's in mode 10. No problem. Okay, let's give him some logic. For we'll call this mode 20. Mode 20. If timer's less than 0. No. We just want to target Jib dead. Set a path to the target. I don't really care about his timer. If mode 20, target Jib dead, set a path, start heading towards the path, animate your idle, set another timer. I don't really need another timer. I guess you could have one though. All right, so if mode, just still in mode 20, target any. This is if mode 20, if target none. This is where he has a target. Target any, if target near, stop. Do one of your saw animations. You've been working on optimizations? So far you made a change will give the laggiest part of the game a 10x performance increase? Dude! Nice work, man. That's incredible. Wow, so what was the laggiest part? What was it? Rendering? Networking? Go. If timer is less than 0, we'll set another timer for like five to 7 seconds again. Oh, we don't need a timer here. Let's make sure the timer is 0 though. And then we can update path too. Kumari, hangover for 27 hours? Oh, man. Bad hangover is the worst. The worst, man. Update path of mode 20, path any, of target far, dir path. Update dir. Mode 20 of target any, of target far, dir target. That's it. Okay, he's got mode 20 now. And I think in what's it, something heroes? Section of the game where you land on planets with tank. Now you have a ton of wiggle room. Yes, dude. Right on, man. High five. That was a high five. Create heroes? Yeah, create heroes. Create heroes. Oh, sweet. Better terrain resolution? Oh, no. Tequila. Ay, ay, ay. Oh, dude. Tequila hangover. Bad. All right, so if Quantity Smith is 3, set the droid Smith into mode 10. Otherwise, if droid Smith Quantity is 5, set him into mode 20 so he works on Jib and not tries to like run around the screen like an idiot. Do it. Do it, droid Smith. Do it. Ooh, this is when he's a hero. I'll have to do some special logic for when he's not a hero then. Ah, it just crashed. Why did you crash and not give me any information? Well, what's the deal here? Invalid behavior? So weird how it overrides part of its text when it gives one of these errors. Target Jib dead. It does not like that. Oh, it's target named. Target named Jib dead. Counterintuitively, crashing the game right there is the best thing to do. You don't want to throw anything because throwing would make it seem like you could catch it. Whoops, whoa. Nice, he's there. He's just trying to get there, but he's like, update der. You're there, man, you're close enough. If mode, you already have a path then? Did you stop your path? I guess we gotta see that in slow motion. All right, I'm getting close to being done with the stream. Getting close. We got about 5 minutes, maybe. Let's turn these two debugging things on. Set it in a little bit of slow motion, too. So we can watch exactly what his AI does. Update dir. He goes straight into update dir mode. Well, there's our problem. All right, so he wants to be if path none here. Path none, man. Don't do that. Do this. Mode 20 of path any of target far. Oh, it's because if this target far thing. Let's try commenting that out. Why does he even have this update dir? Let's try commenting that out too. Nothing? Come on, man. Work on Jib. You know you want to. His AI didn't do anything right there. Just got totally stuck. So either he doesn't have a path or he doesn't have a target. It seems like he didn't even do dirt path 2 either. Yeah, let's make it so he never stops. If so, it's just got if mode 20, if target none. I'm not sure if he ever did sequence to jib either. Turn on render verbosity so we don't have to turn that on every time. And we'll start it up, slow it down. Start it up, slow it down. Do some other stuff in the dad. Nothing. It's like his AI is just dead. I'm not even sure if it said 2-jib. Wait, does it go like... Does it say 2-follow at the beginning? Because that would be wrong. Oh, when he gets created, his quantity might not be 5 yet. Yeah. Oh, he's in 2-follow. Ow. Wait, I'm gonna set a breakpoint here. What are you doing, man? Oh, yeah. Okay, this is where he gets created. He was already created. Oh, okay. Okay, this is a little bit wrong. We do want Jib to be, or him to be in mode 3. So let's set this up here. Yeah, he needs to follow you at first, and then as soon as it does that story element where it switches to mode, or his quantity 5, then it needs to set his mode to be 20. So here's where it starts. Here's where he does want to be started at. Oh, he started mode 8. Oh, this is where he stays. Okay. Right, so he starts in mode 8. Uh-huh. What happens here? Does it do this breakpoint? Yeah, okay, good. Does it again. This time. Quantity Smith is 5. Okay. Mode is 20. But since he's already been running, wait, no, he was just created. Right? His entity AI. This timer. Yeah, he's just started. Mode 0, everything's fine. Yeah, he's starting off totally normal. So, target. Yeah, everything's starting off normal. Okay. So, that was right. We wanted this just to be if quantity Smith equals 5. Set AI mode 20. It must just not be running his behavior correctly. I guess we'll set a breakpoint and target named. So that's probably the first thing we should check is if it's actually setting a target correctly. Say target by name. All right, I think this is the last thing I'm going to be able to do on today's stream. It's crashed last time, that's fine. Don't send a report. All right, HD, see you, man. Good. Okay, it gets into this named. Sturval 1 is Jib dead, but does it find it? Oh, it might not be on the ground yet. Oh, that's what it probably is. Oh, wait, no, it found it. And it sets his target. Oh, okay. Ow. Alright, it's finding him just fine. Okay, but that's so close. It's so close. Something's probably just going wrong here in this little AI. So my goals for after dinner are to go and make it so the droid smith, when he's right here on this home screen, he's gonna just sit there and do his saw, like, and just work on Jib. And after that works, then I'll need to also make it so if you start the game again at that point, or if you come back to that screen at any point, he's always just sitting there working on Jib. So the droid smith will be there at that home screen working on Jib, and that's it till the end of the whole game. And then at the end of the game, if you happen to do this, if you happen to save the animals, then you get an alternate ending to the game. Okay, so thanks a lot for watching, everybody. And I hope y'all have a great night. See y'all next time.